You can put it on the board. Yes.
Welcome to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the Amp.TV mobile studios here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP.TV. Today's show is brought to you by Cali Vegas, helping people create and host their very own radio, TV, or multimedia talk shows. Cali Vegas can help everybody from getting out of sitting in hours of traffic every day or being stuck in their houses like they can't go anywhere and do something productive. And guess what? Host their very own show in their very own home studio. For more information, contact Cali Vegas at 949-445-1119. That's 949-445-1119. Again, 949-445-1119. Or visit them online at calivegas.com. That's CALIVegas.com. And a big welcome to everybody listening in on iHeartRadio, Spotify, and our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast. Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas. Talk 1490 in Southern Alabama, the Florida Panhandle. And a big welcome to everybody streaming at thesportscircus.com, watching us on hotel television from coast to coast, and also, again, here on AMP TV. Back here with Tyrone Poole, two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior. Always looking snappy. Got that top button. Look at me, man. I have mine buttoned all the way up too.
Ah, there you go. Hey, but you got to represent, Sal. You are representing. So at least you're matching. You know, you got the hat. You got a little blue in the hat. You got a little blue in the shirt. Come on. And then, you know, we got the same type of gray. So that Heather gray type, you know, they got so many different colors. But, man, we are matching. We're on it. It's the circus. Hey, listen,
I wore my Garanimals today.
Garanimals.
You remember those?
Okay. Yeah.
You know what Garanimals are?
Those who don't remember what that is.
Oh, come on, man. I mean, you're only a couple years younger than me. You're killing me here.
I said, for those who may not know what you're talking about, you got to bring them up to speed. I didn't say the thing
okay,
about me.
All right. This is for all of those that don't know. Garanimals, I remember this. My mom used to take me to Sears back in about a mile away from where I used to live. There was a big Sears there, and she always used to go and get the popcorn and the snacks. Remember, they always had that, like that hot thing where you can grab that hot popcorn and whatnot. Okay, well, right next to there was like the little kids department, right? The little kids department. And sometimes the kids would go shopping with their parents. Like me, I was stuck for hours with my mom. And I was like, damn, now I'm stuck here again in this chair next to the dressing room. So I had nothing to do. I'm 5-6 years old. And I'm like, man, I got no ice cream. I got no nothing. Cause you know, I like ice cream. Unfortunately, I had nothing to do until Sears came out with Garanimals. So all you had to do as a kid, you had to match up the tags for the kids. So maybe if there was a, I don't know, like a giraffe on one shirt, you'd find a pair of shorts or pants or whatever that also had a giraffe. And now you had a matching set. And those were Garanimals.
There you go. There you go. That's the history of Garanimals. Yes. Thank you for that.
Right, now that we've burnt through the first 5 minutes of the show talking about Garanimals, we have a very special guest right from the outside.
Oh, yes.
And that would be four-time WBC boxing champion and author Bronco Billy Rye.
Bronco.
Hey, what's up, everybody?
There he is. How you guys doing? And there's Billy. Look at Billy's all buttoned all the way up, too.
I wasn't going to get talked to. Like, oh, you know, I worked out sloppy, so I go ahead and I just wanted to follow suit. But I'm afraid what
happened. So here's Billy.
I've only seen you snappy one time.
The last time I saw you wear a button-up shirt or something like that, we went to Jim Fossil's birthday party. Remember that?
Yes, I do. Yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Right here in Las Vegas. All right. So four-time champion over here, two-time champion and American Ninja Warrior over here. And here I am again. We had the same kind of thing yesterday in our show where we had Donnie Schell, Hall of Famer and four-time Super Bowl champion. And then we had this guy over here with two champions and the American Ninja Warrior. And then here's me in the middle with zero championships.
Man, we got a lot of titles on the show today, man. I'm like, a lot of titles have come through just in this hour. So many stories.
Okay,
I'm pretty sure
Billy
got a lot of stories.
Here's how this one works. So this guy over here, he's got four belts. You've got two trophies. I've got 4 degrees. How do you like that?
Well, just, you know what? Yeah.
That's good. That's good. We got all everybody got degrees. We all got degrees too, but that's good, Sal. You got it.
Whatever. It's that's the only it. Way that's I can kind of keep pace here. Right. So here's Billy over here with four WBC belts. He's, I think you were 52-4 with 43 knockouts on top of it. Billy, show everybody the size of your hand. Look at this. I'm going to put my hand up. Billy, you put yours up. Look at that.
Oh, man.
Turn it sideways.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous. That's like an eclipse.
Oh, man.
It's the size of.
Where's the camera?
It's as big as this head right here.
Yeah, no.
It's unbelievable.
Oh.
Yeah, that would leave an imprint. Yeah.
Everybody listening on the radio, you can't see this. So I'm going to paint this picture, the old theater of the mind. I'm going to paint a picture of this eclipse. Now you've got the moon that's coming in front of the sun. Yes. Well, that's kind of what's going on with gigantic Bronco Billy Wright's hand. And so now he's using that hand to write books after a successful fighting career. And now he's a successful author as well. A big round of applause for Billy.
Yes.
Now, Billy, there was a press release that came out recently. I saw it on Fox News. I saw it on the NBC News affiliates. I saw it on the ABC News affiliates, the CBS affiliates. Buddy, you're everywhere. Tell everybody about your book. We'll get into the fighting a little bit, but I want to talk about the book right away.
Yes.
Right. Yeah, Earthly Worlds. I mean, you know, I tell you, you know, people like, I'm not really like the literary kind of guy. I'm a smart guy, you know, whatever, you know, but to sit down like that, I didn't go to school to be an English major or whatever. What happened was, and it's just crazy. June 20th, 2017, I was diagnosed with this little silly brain disease. And it's not silly. It's pretty big. But, and they're like, oh, no, there's no treatment, no cure. You got like, you know, 20 months to live, get your affairs in order. And I'm like going, you don't even know who you're talking to, you know? So instead of getting my affairs in order, me and my kids and a few of my close friends, like just went crazy looking for researching for treatments and for cures and whatever could, you know, extend whatever was happening to me at that time. And so we came up, we started doing stem cell injections. We started doing all these experimental cerebral lysine. And some of the injections I take in my stomach on a daily basis, they don't even have names. They just have letters and numbers. You know, they're so experimental. And it says right on them, not for use in humans. But we went ahead and did it. You know, I took the risk and did it. So what happened was, because they're all nootropic type drugs, they're for the brain to reactivate the, you know, the synapses and things in the brain. So I started having these crazy dreams, right? And I wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning going, what on earth is a leprechaun fish, right? No idea. And so I Google leprechaun fish, doesn't exist. And I'm like, what on earth is going on? So I started taking notes of my dreams. And as a result of my notes from my dreams and my kids like Zachary and Mason, everybody, you know, they're prodding me along. And my good buddy Sal prodding me along. Man, you should write a book. You should write a book. You should write a book. And I'm like, you know what? I don't know how to write a book. And I'm like, oh, just write a book. You'll be able to do it. And so as a result of my dreams, you have Earthly Worlds. So I always tell people, writing makes me sleep. Sleeping makes me dream, and dreaming makes me write. You know, so
there you go.
And it's true. It's how it happened. I mean, when you read Earthly Worlds, let me tell you, it's a magical book. It has fantastic characters that you can only dream of, no pun intended. and truly, you're going to find yourself engaged in the book. The book will draw you into the pages. You will become like intertwined with the characters. Yeah, whatever, dude. You got drawn in. I got drawn in, you know.
Yeah, I know, and, right. Pulled him right in.
And I have, right. And I
you
have,
finally
I have
caught on to that one, right?
Yeah, I got it. Look, it only takes me a second. I catch on. Maybe 10. So,
all right.
So what happened was, I've had a few close people that have read the book, and they're like, Billy, there's only one problem with the book. When you start reading the book, you can't stop reading the book. So it makes you neglect all your duties. If you're a father, you neglect your kids. If you're a business person, you neglect your business. The book won't let you go. So once you start to read Earthly Worlds, it captures you, and you want to keep finding out what happens next. You know, it's just a page turner, and every page draws you in. And I'm not just saying that because I wrote the book. I'm saying that because it truly is just an amazing book. I don't know how I pulled it off. It truly is my dreams, and it's incredible. When you meet Stuart and his family, some of the main characters in the book, you're going to find out that it is what I'm saying.
All right. Wow. We're going to hear more about Earthly Worlds in just a few minutes. Tyrone, take a couple seconds here. Take about 30 seconds. Close us out and get us out. Go to the break.
You know what? Everybody watching from coast to coast, iHeartRadio, Amp TV, hotel television, you are in for another treat. We have a four-time boxing champion, Billy Wright, Bronco. We are coming back with more with Bronco and more of the Sports Circus. Stay tuned. We'll see you in a few.
Do you have any questions about legal issues? Have you ever been stopped by a police officer and issued a ticket that you're scared to deal with? Have you ever been in trouble with the law and don't know what to do? Do you have a will or power of attorney question? Is your home being foreclosed upon and you don't know where to turn? Maybe you were given a contract that you don't understand. For freedom and a worry-free solution, call for Legal Shield today at 213-245-1305. It's that simple. You will have access to high-quality law firms that will fight for you for less than a dollar a day. Peace of mind is just a call away. That's for Legal Shield. Call 213-245-1305 or visit us at nocourt.us. It's justice for all and not justice for some. Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea, the American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.
This is Sal Tuzzolino, host and ringmaster of the Sports Circus. Why listen to the same old dog and pony show that you've heard all day long? The Sports Circus covers everything that other shows don't or are too scared to cover. There's no primetime show like it out here that'll punch you in the mouth and you'll beg for more. You can call in and participate with our chaos if you dare. Join me and celebrity guests for Havoc and Mayhem weekdays at 5 p.m. Pacific here on Amp TV or stream the show live at thesportscircus.com. Remember, folks, it's a circus and we prove it every day.
Numbskulls, I'm broadcasting.
You're listening to the Sports Circus, and I'm Mike Golick.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior Tyrone Poole, joining your Ringmaster Sal, Sonar, and we also have a great guest, Billy Bronco Wright. Together, we are working that thing. We want to welcome all of our viewers from coast to coast, Amp TV, Hotel Television, KIOF 97 FM, Las Vegas, iHeartRadio, Spotify, CBS, NBC, Fox affiliates. We want to thank you guys for joining us. This segment is brought to you by the Tyrone Poole 38 Foundation. If you want to learn more about the TP 38 Foundation, just get your fingers. I'm an index finger person, so just punch on your cell phone, your laptop, your computer. Go to TyronePoole38Foundation.org, and there you can learn more information, and you can even donate. Help us help others. Now, we're turning it back over to your ringmaster, Sal. There he is. All right. Well, you know what? We are going to continue to move and roll this show.
All right. Welcome back to everybody listening in. Hey, listen, folks, it's live. Anything can happen. Big welcome back to everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas. And, of course, Talk 1490 WIRB. Big welcome in to everybody in the Corpus Christi market as well, the greater Houston market. That would be KSIX CBS Sports Radio. 95.1, 96.1, and 12:30 a.m., as well as everybody in Honolulu on CBS Sports 1500, KHKA, KCAA, CBS Sports in Southern California. Big hello to our friends over in Boston on WBNW, Money Matters Radio. For all you finance wizards out there listening to us, hey, you need a break once in a while, too. You know what I mean? All right, and we're back here with Tyrone Poole, as you heard, two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, and four-time WBC boxing champion, Bronco Billy Wright, and Billy author Wright. As well.
Arthur, yes.
Bronco Billy Wright. Yes. You know, I've been saying that for years, Billy. You know, Billy, you've been with the show as a boxing analyst, I think, for over 3 years now, if I'm not mistaken. And I've always wanted to do that ring announcement. I always wanted to do that ring announcement, you know. And in the blue corner, weighing 350 pounds or whatever the heck it is, with a size 95 head and hands as big as the moon, Bronco Billy Wright.
Ding, 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 ding.
Exactly. All right.
I got to ask him this question here. Now, being a professional athlete, he being at the top of his game, being a champion, I've been a champion. I just got to ask you, Billy, what was it like to go in and defend your title? Now, in Super Bowl 38, Super Bowl 39, which was the 2003 NFL season, 2004 NFL season, we defended our title successfully. Now, you going back, what was it like when you won it the first time? What was it like to defend it the second time? Were you a little bit more nervous, or you a little bit more cautious, or what was your attitude going in defense of that second time? Or any defense of the title?
Yeah, you know, when you go in, like, you know, because I defended my title 22 consecutive times, and it was intense. Like, it was intense. We, every time, like, you know, like, I fought this guy one time from Brazil. He was 23-0 with 21 knockouts. You know, and you think, okay, because I'm fighting the toughest guys in the world, trying to, you know, and so I'm like, going, all right, this guy, maybe I was excited. I thought maybe it was going to be a battle. Like, I thought this could be, so I'm all nerved up and excited and all hyped up. And as soon as I hit this guy and he yelped like a little puppy, I was like, what? You know, and so, you know what I mean? Like, and that was the guy that I fought on the Roy Jones Jr. undercard. And I busted three of his ribs with a body shot, and the fight was over, you know? So you train so hard. It's a little different than football because we train so hard. I don't got to play a full game. You know, like, there's not, like, four quarters where you got to be on every minute, every second of every game, of every quarter, of everything you're doing, right? And you have to be in – when you're in the ring and it's live, of course you got to be on. But in this case, the fight lasted a minute and 30 seconds. I trained for 8 weeks – to fight a minute and 30 seconds, you know? So as they always say, you know, I always say, you know, train hard, fight easy. I was always pretty, I wouldn't say I was overconfident, but I was confident because I know, you know, like, my abilities, and I know how hard I've trained my entire life as a serious athlete. And I, you know, and at everything we do, we apply ourselves, you know, 100%, 100% a father, 100% a fighter, 100% a writer now, you know, 100% a friend. And we mean South and friends for years and years. And I won't, like, I don't do things halfway. And so I know, like, you know, when you prepare for your football games and stuff, you know what you've done. Everyone knows what they've done. So you know when you're going to get on that field that when I get in the ring, I've done my job, so we're going to fight. It's time to play, you know? And it's more, my nerves are more, would have been more, I don't want to let anybody down. So hopefully, you know, this guy doesn't get a lucky shot, you know what I mean, or some crazy thing and take you out early. And so you get that kind of, you know, so your nerves are more from a disappointment standpoint, not to disappoint your friends and family.
Gotcha. That's true. Yes.
And you, I agree. Right? I mean, what was your thing? What made you nervous?
It, like you said, Billy, is you don't want to disappoint. For me, my peers, my teammates. So it was always good to have that competition amongst us. The competition was never against the team. It was amongst us, like you. I believe boxing is one of the purest one-on-one, mano-a-mano sport. Is you are the only one in that ring. It's almost like track and field would probably be the only other sport where it's you against yourself. Your competition is just there, but it's you against the clock. So in boxing, I think it's the purest one-on-one sport. It's you against yourself. And if you do what you've been practicing on, then like you said, you should defeat your opponent with hands down. You know. So for me, fear was just I didn't want to let my peers down. And my teammates. So, yeah, I get you with that. It was never the fear of someone else. It was the fear of me not letting down those who know what I can do.
Yeah, because there's so many distractions. We have so many distractions in life. And, you know, and coming up to the fights, you know, we have trainers, people that run with you, people that live with you. You know, then you got your fight trainers that are in the boxing gym with you. And then, you know, we have nutritionists telling you what to eat, when to eat, and all that kind of stuff. And I don't really have a nutritionist right now. So,
well, in your part, Billy, it was like who to eat, right?
It was who to eat, right? It was funny, like when I fought on the Roy Jones undercard against this guy from Brazil, right? We were at the weigh-ins, and we did the weigh-in, the stare down thing, whatever, you know. And so, my pre-fight dinner, I had this big rack of ribs. I said, I'm going to have ribs for dinner, and I'm going to have ribs for lunch. You know what I mean? So, cracking up and stuff. But it's kind of serious. Like, you know, you got some guy in your face in a press conference calling you old and fat and that kind of stuff. I want to knock him out right on the spot. You know what I mean? So, you know, you got to save it for fight night, you know? So, because at the time when I fought that fight, I was, at that time, Sal, I was 52 years old when I knocked that guy out.
He was 23.
Well, so what I remember, I mean, we had this conversation almost 3-4 years ago, and it was like, okay, Billy, what haven't you done in the ring? And what Billy had said, and I'll never forget this, I've never broken somebody's collarbone. That's on your bucket list of breaking things, is it not?
Yeah, you know, I busted ribs, I busted jaws, I busted noses, I've knocked teeth out. I busted a guy's arm, punched him in the back of his arm because he kept having his arms up. And it was Chauncey Welliver. Fractured his arm above the elbow. And I'm like, I like to punch somebody like right in the shoulder area, right in the collarbone and break their collarbone. I'm not a violent, crazy person. So this is only inside the ring. It's okay. Outside of the ring, we don't do this. Inside the ring, it's okay. So I'm just saying that to everyone that's going to listen and watch him. We don't do this outside the ring. So inside the ring, I've always wanted to punch somebody and break their collarbone. I just thought it would be fun, you know, like something that no one else has done. I don't know anybody else has done it, you know?
Let me ask you this, Bill. Is there someone that you didn't fight in the boxing ring that you would say, you know what, I would buy all the tickets myself just to get this guy in the ring so I could fight him? Was there any type of boxer?
I offered to fight Dante Wilder and Vladimir Klitschko. I said, I'll fight you for free. I'll fight them guys for free. They don't have to pay me, I'll fight them. But
right, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, that's not.
Well, the punching power. The punching power of Deontay Wilder, I would argue, would be really a big challenge. And I mean, can you withstand one of those? But the bigger question is, could he withstand one of yours? He obviously couldn't withstand that from Tyson Fury. And I would argue that you would probably hit as hard as Tyson Fury.
Yeah, I love Tyson Fury. I love Tyson Fury. He's like an old, greasy truck driver. You know what I mean? And he's just as tough and has more to say. It's just, I love Tyson Fury. He's a great guy, man. Tyson Fury's awesome.
I love the fact that after he wins the title and he starts singing. And I love that he was serenading everybody. All right, Billy, listen, we've got 20 seconds. Give everybody your final thoughts on singing after a championship win.
You sing. You sing all the way. I don't know what to say. You know,
come on, man, what do you got?
I love to sing. What do you sing? I don't even know what you're saying. You're pow, pow.
Nothing.
Sing, pow, pow. I'm so happy.
I just wanted to put you on the spot. Folks, we're going to be back here with Bronco Billy Wright, four-time WBC champion and author, yes, as well as Tyrone Poole, two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, and myself, the guy with the biggest head in the room. Don't go anywhere. Back in a few.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm Roy Firestow. Now it's time to throw it back to Sal.
My favorite one had to do with the Green Bay Packers. And I love the fact that they dealt off Ty Montgomery because of a blown assignment. Green Bay isn't Green Bay unless they have a good running game. Then they can win 10 Super Bowls. The fact is, you don't have a running game. You've got 70% passing, and that's not where Aaron Rodgers needs to be. He needs to be in a position where he's got a running game to offset the passing game and so forth. I like the move. Green Bay didn't have a running game anyway, so all they're doing is saying, we're going to get rid of you because you don't follow instructions.
Well, he made one of the most boneheaded plays I've ever seen. There's 2 minutes and 5 seconds on the clock. They traded him
on
Tuesday.
They should have cut him on Sunday
night.
He
shouldn't have been on the plane back to Green Bay.
Right, they should have made him walk back to Green Bay.
No, it was a terrible play. Now, he's not a stupid guy. He went to Stanford.
Really?
He's not a dumb guy.
He's not a dumb guy, but he doesn't follow instructions.
He made a terrible play.
The fact is, he didn't follow instructions. And you say he's not a dumb guy. His own agenda he put ahead of his team.
I agree.
Thus, he is a dumb guy. Right or wrong?
Wrong. He just got selfish. You're not going to convince me that a guy from Stanford is a dum-dum.
No!
this is Sydney Justin from the Miracles.
So you heard yesterday's show at Roy Firestone. Didn't you hear a little clip about him going into the office where Smokey was at? And that was really good material, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was really funny, man.
Yeah, and then you heard him.
It was hilarious. It was cool, though. It was cool. Really cool story, man. I enjoyed listening to that.
Right, and then he gave a little bit of a couple of bars. Can you give us a couple of more from Ooh Baby Baby? And let's see if you could do it better than Roy Firestone. Come on, man!
You know what? Why not? I did you wrong. My heart went out to play, but in the game I lost you. What a price to pay. Hey, I'm crying. Ooh, baby, baby.
How's
that, man?
That's
Is that okay? Is that
man.
Good enough?
That's incredible.
That's fantastic.
You know why? Because that's what you do. You're in the incredible business, Sid. That's awesome. Yes! Only at the Sports Circus. You're going to get sports. You get music.
Can't beat fun at the old ballpark, friends.
Hey, everybody. This is Barry Katz from the Industry Standard Podcast, and you're listening to the Sports Circus with Sal Tuzzolino.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the Amp.TV mobile studios here out in front of the Welcome to Las Vegas sign here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's WAMP.TV. Folks, this segment is brought to you by Earthly Worlds. Earthly Worlds was written by four-time WBC boxing champion and our boxing analyst, Bronco Billy Ride. Bronco Billy, tell everybody about Earthly Worlds.
Hey, everybody. It's Earthly Worlds is a magical book. It's a fantasy fiction book. And, it takes you on an incredible journey through magical worlds filled with fantastical beasts and creatures of all kinds. And you'll find yourself falling in love with the different creatures and characters. And you'll be drawn to the book. And it's a very, very, very good book. And it's for all ages. You know, I would definitely call it a PG book. And, it's a great book on Amazon.com, on Kindle. You can get the book. If you're Amazon Prime, I think you can read them for free. So, all that stuff. So yeah, it's a great book. And I would definitely recommend it. Not just because I wrote it, because it really is a good book. Sal.
I think you need to say it's a great book a few more times. Go ahead. It's okay.
Yeah, no, it's a great book. Really, it's a great book.
Really. It's a great book. Tyrone, don't you think it's a great book?
It's a great book. Yeah,
it's a great book.
Forget about it. No, really, it's a good book. Hey, forget about it.
Hey,
I hear it's a great book.
Great. So we're going to steal that one.
All right, and a big welcome back to everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast. Also, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas. And everybody watching on hotel television from coast to coast in 650,000 rooms. Listen, go to Amazon and look for Earthly Worlds from this guy. This behemoth of a monster knows how to write, and he's a good way. Get your finger out of my ear, mister. Everybody watching this on television can see a split screen with three guys. I got Tyrone on my left, me in the middle, and of course, there is Double Pumpkin Head or Bronco Billy Wright on the right side. Now, great stuff. Welcome back, everybody.
Now, Billy and I were talking, right? And he also mentioned that he played football. A lot of people don't know that. Not only was he a champion in the boxing ring, but as we were talking, he was a doggone heck of a D lineman. And he told me the story where the offense would just literally run away from him. But the one thing that stood out that he said is that he did 225 53 times. Now, I had to go look that up. Billy challenged me. He said, I want to know what is the record in the NFL combine. Now, you wouldn't know the NFL just had the combine. So 225 is one of the exercises they do. Now, I looked it up. And 51 reps by Justin Ernest in 1999 from Eastern Kentucky. He did it 51 times. So, Bronco, man, not only are you a champion in the boxing ring, but, man, you go to the combine right now, you'll be the champion doing 225. I'm like, wow, 53 times, man. That's a lot.
Yeah, that's a lot.
It is. Yeah, it was just kind of like I just wanted to see it. So it took about probably a month of training. I was already in shape. And 225 is my warm-up weight. We do like a couple sets of 25 or 30 just to get warmed up with the 225 weight anyway. So it's not really a heavy weight to me. And I could always do it like 40, 45 reps, and then I'd tucker out and I couldn't do any more. So we started training to like get harder. And so I started doing reps with the three wheels. And I got three wheels like 28 times one time. You know what I mean? And I went towards the end of it when I was in the best shape. And three wheels, I think, is like 305, right? Isn't three wheels 305? 315. Yeah, 315, something like that. Yeah. So 28 reps was my record with the three wheels. And that's when I could do 225 53 times. Because you get so used to repping that big mama. You take the wheels off and you only got two wheels on there and it's easy. It's like bump, 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 bump. And but I can tell you the last couple, I was like at 51 going, just shaking, getting them last two out, We got 53, and we just did it for kicks and grins, just to see how many we could do.
Yeah, I'm at the I think I'm at the steal that term from you, two wheels. So I normally would say put on 2 45-pound plates, but I'm going to start saying now put on 2 wheels on each side. So it'll make me feel like I'm stronger. When I hear wheels, I think about a car. So I'm like, man, 2 wheels, I'm lifting a car, man. So I got to steal that term from you. I'm going to say put on 2 wheels on both sides.
That's right.
That's a lot of.
Oh, man.
Well, I mean, let me say, but I weigh 325, 330 pounds. And so I'm supposed to be able to do that. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And you've actually slimmed down quite a bit, too, Billy.
Yeah. Because
you were a little bit more than that at one time. You were 400 before.
Yeah, we got to 400 once. Yeah.
What did you do? What did you do for all those people? Because there's a lot of people out there right now who are trying to find that magic pill, which I tell them there are no magic pills when it comes to losing weight. What did you actually do to actually drop that weight that you can actually help somebody who is watching or listening to this show that, hey, you know what? This is what I did, and I lost the weight.
Yeah. What I did, and it was very hard because I love the treats. I love the sugar, okay? And so for me, how I kind of gradually weaned myself off of it, you know, by percentages. I would eat like, you know, half. I cut my sugar in half and then drank more water, you know. So I increased my water intake and I decreased my sugar intake. And then by the end of a month, I was done. I stopped eating sugar altogether and I was drinking the recommended water for my body weight and, you know, like a gallon and a half a day of water. And then no sugar. And I shook like 60 pounds in 2 months without any extra, without running, without anything. Just, I mean, I dropped from 400, you know, down to 340 just like that. So it wasn't that bad. I mean, you know, it really wasn't that bad. I thought I was going to miss the sugar. But I really didn't. I really didn't after a month of kind of cutting back. I did. So it wasn't that hard. I reckon, you know, anybody can do it. If I can do it, you guys can do it. Cause I'm telling you, I'd love some cookies. You know what I mean? So you guys, anybody can do it. You just got to do it.
Well, Tyrone trains people. Tyrone is etched out of a stone. And he's got like 1%, 2% body fat. It's ridiculous.
Look how chiseled he is.
Look at me. I've got an extra chin, right?
Yeah, you know what they call that, Sam?
I've got enough chin for everybody here.
Sal, you know they call that what you just pulled on, that extra neck right there? They call it chicken neck, the turkey neck. Isn't it turkey neck? The turkey had that little hanging, you know, right there?
Mine is, I got a cookie neck.
You got the gobbler.
It's a cookie neck.
Oh, man, that's wild. But, man, that is good.
But
Tyrone
treats people. Sugar. Billy, give me the sugar. You should see it. Bill, you should see this guy's videos. I mean, he really trains people. I mean, literally, when he showcases himself. I mean, he's got the full washboard. This guy is big. Tyrone, go ahead and make a muscle into the camera because you can.
No, man, I know what I want to. I want to dive. I want to get some more information from Billy. Now we were talking. Now we were talking about the streets, right? We were talking about the streets. I know Sal tried to put me on the set, you know, but I did. That's why I got the button up. You know, I'm in my. Let's interview the great champion,
right.
Billy Bronco Wright. So it's all about Billy right now and a little bit about you, Sal. But anyways, Billy and I was talking. He was saying how he came up in the streets. And we just talked about the mindset of all great athletes, that there's some type of principle when you look at it, when you ask this champion, whether it's in boxing or it's in basketball, football, or it's just a champion in life, I believe that there are principles that we all can extract from each other and say, hey, you know what? I did that very same thing. So Billy was talking about how he came up in the streets. Now, I said the same thing. I'm listening to Billy. I said, you know what? It's similar to me. Now, when I say grew up in the streets, meaning I believe that there's a lot of learning and a lot of competition in the streets. It's almost like private school versus public school. Public school would be, so to speak, like the streets. Private school would be like, okay, you stayed in the house, you didn't ever do anything. But when you go out in the streets, you have to learn how to run fast. You have to learn to be quick on your feet, to outthink. So I think everybody who grew up in the streets, not that it's bad, but there are opportunities to learn in different environments. So when Billy shared that with me, I just thought, man, wow, it's such similarities of champions. And when you look at their lives, so that was a great. And Billy, if you want to share a little bit more about that, about growing up in the streets and how it taught you how to be a champion.
Yeah, more than anything, like you said, I learned to run really fast when I was a kid because I didn't like getting beat up. I was a skinny little kid, and I learned to run fast, and I wasn't afraid to run. You know, if I saw three or four guys coming to me, I was gone. Pew! You know, and I ran from every foster home. Dude, I ran away from every foster home I got put in, you know. So I was a fast little kid, and I was hard to catch because I was tricky. I was tricky fast. You know, I was able to cut back and forth all over the place. And we don't got time for the story for the Kingman. The Kingman, the police had to chase me down one time when I was like 11. But we'll talk about another time. But quick or whatever. It's good. You know, I would say if anything else, it just teaches you to be independent. You know, it teaches you to be independent, and your fear level changes. Like your fear levels are different. You know, like I'm not afraid of some things that maybe another person would be. You know. So I'll push myself a little further in some areas other people won't.
Yeah, right. That's good.
All right, guys, I want you to hold that thought. I want you to hold that because we're going to be back here in just a few minutes. We're going to take a quick commercial break. Back here with four-time WBC boxing champion and author Bronco Billy Wright and two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior Tyrone Poole. Back here in a few minutes. Don't go anywhere.
Do you own a timeshare? Well, face the facts. You made a mistake. You made a bad purchase. A timeshare is not an investment. It's a money pit that continues forever. If you use your timeshare, that's great. But if you don't and you want to legally get out of your contract, call my friends right now at the Timeshare Exit Hotline. They're an experienced team of lawyers who help good people like you get out of a timeshare contract that they just don't want. Don't throw away your money on maintenance fees. Use it for things you really want. We can help you end your timeshare contract and stop the money drain immediately. If you're ready to move on with your timeshare, call our team right now.
Cancel your timeshare now with a free call. 800-741-9557. 800-741-9557. 800-741-9557. That's 800-741-9557. Can your IRA stand up to the next financial crisis that our top economists are saying is at our doorsteps? By allocating a percentage of your IRA into physical gold and silver with a tax-free rollover, you can diversify and safeguard your holdings from turbulent markets and economic downturns by putting your IRA back on the gold standard. Find out how to safeguard your assets with a tax-free rollover with a Genesis Gold IRA, the only IRA that can hold physical precious metals. Call now for your free gold and silver report. Protect your IRA today with one simple phone call and learn how to qualify for up to $10,000 in free silver. Call Genesis Gold Group, empowering faith-driven stewardship. 800-932-5517. 800-932-5517. 800-932-5517. That's 800-932-5517.
That's the sound of sizzling, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks from UppercutChops.com. They're best-in-class filet mignons, New York steaks, and the king of all steaks, the tomahawk and cowboy cut ribeyes are the best in the business. Even their Prime Wagyu burgers will likely be the best you've ever had. Browse the full selection of steaks and chops at UppercutChops.com from the comfort of your home or on your mobile device. UppercutChops.com delivers all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks and chops directly to your door without the hassle of going to the grocery store and fight crowds to pick from a small selection of average and best meats with injected steroids, fillers, and coloring added to look good. Find out what's for dinner at UppercutChops.com or call 702-799-9935. That's 702-799-9935. 702-799-9935. Or make your selection directly at UppercutChops.com.
Hey, this is Tommy John, and you're listening to the Sports Circus.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your ringmaster, Sal, live from the Amp.TV mobile studios right out here in front of the Vegas sign in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP.TV. Check them out. An important message for consumers, business owners, and managers for information on the best high-speed internet, satellite TV, cell phone service, identity protection, home and business security and automation, credit card processing, plus savings on electricity and gas bills. Contact 702-799-9935 for more information. That's for smart savings on home and business services. Contact 702-799-9935, 702-799-9935, or visit them online for more information at safelyspend.com. That's safelyspend.com. And welcome back to everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, as well as iHeartRadio, Spotify, and those watching on hotel television in 650,000 rooms from coast to coast, as well as AMP TV, AAMP.TV, and those streaming at thesportscircus.com. A big also hello to Chris Christian, who's watching us over in the greater Dallas market. Chris, thanks for tuning in. Back here with Tyrone Poole, two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior. Look how fired up he gets every time you say that. He gets really fired up. Love that.
Got to get fired up for you, Sal. I got to keep your energy, man.
Listen,
you
bring I'm fired energy up every day.
I got to match what it is? It's
I'm fired up every day because I watch cartoons. That's why.
That's why you fired up. See, I'm fired up because it's like the mentality, like I'm pretty sure I would guess Billy Bronco Wright has. I got to match your energy. So if you want to ding, ding, you come out swinging, I got to come out swinging with you. So come
on. All right. And he's referring. And of course, Tyrone is referring to the guy that's working the speed bag over to my right. And that would be four-time WBC boxing champion and author, hopefully soon to be best-selling author, Bronco Billy Wright.
Earthy world. Come on, Earthy world.
Yeah.
By the way, so let's cover that book for just a moment, because I hear it's a good book. That's what I've heard.
It's, it's a fantastic book. It's a great book. It's a great book.
Look, it's Tyrone the Tiger over here. It's a great book. All right, so
world.
You can
take the journey.
Earthly Worlds. Tell everybody about Earthly Worlds again, Billy.
I just tell everybody, take the journey. Earthly Worlds will take you on a journey you've never been on before, ever in your life, because it's a great book. And it's magical. It's filled with magical characters, with fantastical beasts and creatures that you can only imagine up. And it really is, you know, you got the light elves and the dark elves and all kinds of creatures. I mean, you got Baron Tyrus, who's the dark lord of the dark magical worlds. And he is incredibly just like he's chiseled out of granite, this 7 foot tall, towering, like just, I won't say monster because he's not a monster, but he is a monster for how he behaves and the things he does. But it's an amazing book. The House of Thrym, Jorath, and the Dark Elves versus, like, you know, you got the Light Elves and the Bright Elves. There's even like a dino moose. There's a moose so gigantic in this book. It has villages of critters that live on this moose. And it like it's so majestic and so amazing. You have to read the book. Like, this book will take you on a journey, honestly, like no other you've ever been on. It really is incredible. It really is a great book.
And you can find it at Amazon.com, Earthly Worlds. I just want to know, how in the world do you have villages? How do you think of this stuff? Villages of critters on arms and the names. How do you come up with the names of characters? Did this just one day magically come together, or did you throw a bunch of stuff into a blender, kind of mix it up a little bit? Hey, let's pour out some creative drink. And oh, by the way, it happens to be a fantastic book.
Yes. And you know what happens? Like, you know, we talked about it earlier in the show about the brain disease and all the treatments, all the medicine that I'm taking stuff. It's crazy. Like, you truly, I dream these things. Like, I literally visually, in my dreams, saw these characters. These were their names in my dreams. It wasn't like I had to create a name. These like the things that I'll describe it's a very descriptive book. It's a very visual book. When you read the book, you'll literally be able to see it come to life around you. And that's why it draws you in so well. You're literally reading my dreams. It's just amazing.
Okay, so here, Billy, you are a boxer turned author. And this guy over here is a football player and an author as well, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. Now, you have a book too, Tyrone, don't you?
Yes, I do. But it's probably not as great as Billy's book, but it matches his energy. But my book is called Ultimate Success in the Game of Life. Basically, it's 12 dynamic principles that, again, principles work for anybody. So I've found out over my course of life up to this point of being successful Super Bowl champion that there were 12 principles that helped me get there. So the principles, they work for me, they work for anyone. So just like Billy, I'm an author. Anybody want to find more information about Ultimate Success in the Game of Life, TyronePool38.com. Great book. Just like Billy, Bronco Wright, our books are great. Now go buy them. You'll be Bronco saying Billy great Wright as well.
What are the odds of me having on the show at the same time two champions, multiple champions, that is, and two authors? Awesome. Now, that doesn't happen very often. I think that's a very first for the Sports Circus. Big round of applause for the Sports Circus and MTV as well.
Let's go pull the slots now. Let's go pull the slot. Go pull the slot, Sal, because we know you're sitting between two lucky guys, so that luck is falling on you. Go pull the lever on one of those slot machines, and let's hear it go bing, 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 and watch all the cards fall out.
Well, the good news, I actually have a slot machine at home, so I don't have to spend money in the casinos to go do it. Hey, once my money runs out, I open the gate up, I take my money out, and I put it right back in again.
Yeah, I know, right?
That's hilarious. Go ahead.
Now, check this out. Billy. I want to ask Billy, you know, I was like, go ahead, Billy. You want to say something?
No, I was just telling Sal, that's a win-win.
There you win-win. You can't do that. Double for your trouble. That's a win-win. We were talking about family. We were talking about family. And I have a son. I have a 19-year-old daughter. She's a sophomore, runs track, 400 meters, 200 meters. My son, he's 13. It's kind of like that movie, The Incredibles. You know, really don't know what he's going to be. He's so gifted and talented. Right. But the reason why I bring that up, because Billy has kids, and we talk about, again, the principles of champions. How if you look at the father, usually there's going to be something that your father did to help instill that champion mentality to you. Myself, I'm doing the same thing with my kids. So Billy shared a story, and I'm going to let him share his story, but I'm going to share my personal story with my son. My son, when he was like maybe 6 years old, we've all heard of that syndrome, flight or fight syndrome, right? So I'm wrestling with my son, you know, just playing with him, you know, toughing him up a little bit. So actually I trapped him, meaning I put my body weight on him, not to crush him, but to make it difficult to see if he was going to fight or was he going to flight, give up. So he tried to, you know, get from up under me to my left side. I'll move to my left side. He tried to move to the right side. I'll move to the right side. So I'm like, okay, is he going to say, oh, stop, stop, daddy, you're hurting me, you're hurting me. No, he didn't do that. He got even tougher. He like, hold on. I'm like, whoa, I like that mentality. So he showed me right there that he had developed the attitude of fight. When he get trapped in a situation, he's going to fight. So, Billy, I know you shared a story with me, how you and your kids, how you guys would have that WWE type of testing in your household to make your kids understand what champions think and feel like. So share that story with everybody.
Yeah, I always tell everybody, and I mean this with all sincerity, my greatest success stories are my children. My greatest success stories are my children. I feel very lucky and very, very fortunate to have such children that just push themselves and achieve great things. You know, they're college graduates or they're in college or on the way to college. But we have all my sons, even my daughters will try me too, my older daughters, you know, or all my boys, you know, they grow up big. Like, you know, my 18-year-old's like 6'7". All my boys are, you know, 6'3", 6'4". You know, they're all big and they're big guys too. Like, so, you know, in their whole life, even my little 11-year-old, you know, he's like 5'2", and he's always, you know, he wants to jump on me all the time. But we have, like, it literally turns into WWE because they want that rite of passage. They want to be able to be the first one that took dad down, you know? And, you know, you exactly. can't ever let him, you know, you let him kind of win, but you don't let him win, you know?
Yes.
And, you know, they always say them little dad tricks, you know, to be able to pull out the last second ankle grab, right, and get free. Because I'll have, like, three of them on top of me, you know? And this is like WWE at our house, around, especially on the holidays. Especially on the holidays. So it's awesome. But we all know, Sal, we all kind of grew up in them rough households, you know, where we, oh, yeah. we pass it on.
I was the youngest in a house of eight, and everybody used me as the punching bag until I got bigger than everybody else. It's a different story. Then my dad had to step in and say, no, don't touch your sister. And my sister, she grew up to be a bodybuilder on top of it. Figure that one out, right?
Wow. That's tough, though.
It did. So, Billy, listen, we have a couple of minutes left, and I want you to talk, take 30 seconds and say, if Earthly Worlds is a good book for parents maybe to read their kids. Now, I know you've got young kids, right? And I know there's a lot of people listening in the audience. What is the age range for Earthly Worlds? Isn't it an all-ages media audience, an all-ages audience, I should say? Or what's the sweet spot for it?
Yeah, Zachary is my 31-year-old son. He's got four kids, and every night he reads Earthly Worlds to them. They'll read a chapter or so every night. He reads them to sleep with Earthly Worlds since it's been out. So they love the book. It's a very, like I said, it's PG. You got some, like, the fight scenes between the Dark Elves and the Light Elves and the battle scenes and stuff, but nothing. There's no cursing, no violence against kids or women. Like, there's nothing. There's no sexual content. There's nothing of any bad nature that children couldn't really hear. You know, even in Princess of the Bride, they have the dungeons and the torture scenes. So, but it's a good book, and it's I would say family friendly, definitely. And like I said, my son reads it to my four grandkids every night.
So it appeals to all crowds, and that's really what I'm after. Okay, good.
Yes. Yeah.
And everybody can find the Earthly Worlds at Amazon.com. And if you're an Amazon Prime member, as I am, as a lot of people are these days, I believe you can download it for free. But also, there are paperbacks and hard copies available too, the hardback covers. I'm actually wanting the hardback cover because it's kind of good for the coffee table. It's good for the library and so forth. That's the kind of thing that I'm looking for. So how do we get those, Billy?
Same thing. Go to Amazon.com. You can order the books through Amazon. Everything's available on Amazon. Or you can go, if you want to message me on Facebook or message me on Instagram or something, or message me through the Sports Circus.
All right. Big thanks for Tyrone Poole, two-time Super Bowl champion, joining us, American Ninja Warrior, and Bronco Billy Wright, four-time WBC boxing champion, author. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, and we'll see you next time. We're out of time, folks.
So, you want to be in show business. Do people tell you that you're really funny, you have a great personality, and you should have your own talk show? Many of us have been told that, but we don't know how to get started. It's easier than you think. Let the pros at Cali Vegas give you a free talent evaluation. Call 949-445-1119 and learn how quickly you can create, produce, and host your very own talk show. Imagine not having to sit in traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job. Get started in television or radio today with your free talent evaluation from Cali Vegas. Call 949-445-1119 or visit them online at calivegas.com. Make your dream come true today and create your new career and learn how to become a television or radio star with the help of Cali Vegas. 949-445-1119. Call now.